the heart of a fan.
High above in the Rocky Mountains of Denver, Colorado, the Columbus Blue Jackets are rested and ready to go here in the Mile High City. Led by Captain Boo Jenner, who took the previous game into his own hands in dramatic fashion, helping propel a come-from-behind victory. On the other end of the ice stands Colorado's Nathan MacKinnon, along with Avs captain Gabriel Landeskog, look to overcome a plethora of early season team injuries. It's the Avs and the Jackets next, right here on Bally Sports. Beautiful downtown Denver, the Mile High City, the backdrop as the Avalanche play host to your Columbus Blue Jackets. Good evening, everybody. Jeff Rimmer along with Jody Shelley, and welcome to Blue Jackets hockey on Bally Sports. And after that come-from-behind win Sunday in New Jersey, Jody, Jackets close out the three-game road trip, and they're looking for some consistency.
Yes, that's a great word, consistency. And you know what? What a win. Come back like that. It's a team that has a couple good wins, a couple losses they'd want back, but right now facing the best, one of the best in the National Hockey League, in the Colorado Avalanche in a home-and-home series, this is when you bring it.
And I like where you're going. The best. And certainly Nathan MacKinnon is one of them. So the Jackets centerman looking for a big game here tonight.
Yeah, exactly. And the center ice position is such a critical part of the Blue Jackets, any team really. And coming into this season, it was one of those question marks. Boone Jenner was actually on the wing to start, but he's their top centerman when it comes to those numbers, 60% in that dot. Cole Sillinger, the 18-year-old, he's moved up in the lineup. 45% on the draws. You know, he's a plus minus as good. He's a plus one. He's doing a nice job, and he's getting rewarded for it. Roslovic, not happy. Doesn't have a goal yet this year. He's over 50% on the faceoff dot. He's a guy that's improving in that. Tonight he plays with two rookies in Hoffman and then Chinnikov. Corrali, a good veteran, understands his game extremely well and takes care of those details. Doing a nice job on the dot.
And with Max Domi out due to COVID protocol, it presents an opportunity for Yegor Chinnikov, and he is our Kia player profile.
Yeah, here's a guy, and opportunity is the key word, Jeff, because, you know, he's been in the lineup, and you get excited as a player, as an athlete, to get in there and really have an impression and make your mark and stay in, but it hasn't worked out for him. So now another chance to get here. He's on the right side. The left is Hoffman. Hoffman is a forechecker. He is so anxious to get after the pucks. Jack Roslovic is the playmaker. So he has two shooters on his wings. Let's see if these guys can have an impact on this game tonight.
Our Elk injury report, and the Avalanche have an extensive list of players out.
Yeah, you're talking about some, not just the number of players, but how about the key members? Cale Makar plays an average of 25 minutes a game. One of the top young defensemen in the National Hockey League. That's a lot of minutes. Rantanen, he averages a big amount too at 21:57, almost 22 minutes. So those guys have to be replaced there. The other guys as well, valuable pieces. The Blue Jackets cannot take that for granted, though.
Well, two players that are in their lineup. Let's start with Nathan MacKinnon.
Yeah, well, this is a superstar. 2013 first overall pick. He's 26 years old now, almost at averaging a point a game. He's that type of player. 2,100 shots, almost 3.6 shots per game, and that's what he brings. He's a shooter, he's a playmaker. His legs and his hands are remarkable. Demands a lot in practice, a lot in games. He understands the pressure of Vegas picking the Colorado Avalanche to be the Stanley Cup champions after the year. He wants it, and he's trying to drive his team to that championship.
And what about his winger and the captain of the Avs, Gabriel Landeskog?
Yeah, if you're going to have a dynamic duo, you got to, who's the other guy, right? The captain is the other guy. There's only been two captains in Colorado Avalanche history, Joe Sakic and this guy. And I love Gabriel Landeskog. He's out of Stockholm, Sweden, second overall in 2011. He's 6'1", 215, 11th season with the Avalanche, and he can play it any way you want. He's gritty, he goes to the hard areas, stands up for his teammates. He knows the temperature of the team at all times. You know, we just showed the board of all those injuries. These two guys will not make that an excuse. They want to drive this game tonight for the Avalanche.
So, the countdown to the opening faceoff. You see now, less than 3 minutes, the Jackets conclude their three-game road trip here in the Mile High City. Columbus Blue Jackets hockey brought to you by your local Toyota dealer. Visit buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places. By Gallagher Sharp Defense Firm. Four offices across Ohio and Michigan. Gallagher Sharp is your litigation and business law firm that provides solutions and not surprises. And by CarShield. CarShield can go farther. And our starting goaltenders this evening, Jonas Korpisalo. Second consecutive start for the first time this season. And Jonas Johansson gets the start tonight for the Avalanche.
Just second start for Johansson. Interesting here. Kemper's played all the games except one for the Avalanche. He's done a nice job, the veteran netminder. And Jonas Korpisalo going for back-to-back starts here. Elvis gets over a week rest.
How about the Toyota keys to the game, Jody?
The Blue Jackets tonight here against Colorado. You know, you look at the lineup, you think, oh, there's some big guys out. But they need to take care of the details. You cannot feed the transition game of the Colorado Avalanche. Frustrate them on the PK. Their best players are out there. Nathan McKinnon wants to drive it. Try to frustrate them. Keep them back and get into that fun dip. You've watched social media of the Columbus Blue Jackets. Pre-game rituals. One is get that fun dip out and have some fun. Why not, Jeff?
And the Jackets win the opening faceoff. McKinnon with a drop feed, and it sails all the way back into Colorado territory. Jackets in their traveling whites. Home dark jerseys for Colorado. This is Girard now. Quickly, heads up ice. Heels it on the wing there for Landeskog. Steered behind the net. Picked up here along the near wall and tossed to the far side. Laine will get there ahead of a familiar face, Jack Johnson, earning a spot. Came here on a PTO without a deal as McKinnon tried to walk right in. He's drawn a penalty, and Colorado will go to the power play.
Well, how about that? The Blue Jackets managing the puck, the details. Well, the puck didn't get deep enough, and Nathan McKinnon saw open ice and white jerseys heading toward the bench, and as he did, he just winds it up. Here he goes. He can see all those players trying to get back through the middle of the ice. First shift for Laine, about 2 seconds long. And he's going to go to the bench. That's a tough start when you hop on the ice and see that speed of McKinnon ripping through the neutral zone with the puck.
Colorado, 28th on the power play, off to a disappointing start in that regard at 12.9%. Blue Jackets on the kill at 22nd in the league at 77.8%. Nice play here, tossed in front, and it's Corrali out there with Eric Robinson who finds some room and dumps it deep. Hiram now, quarterback of the power play, in the absence of Cale Makar. Landeskog quickly feeds it ahead. Quick shot there, it's off the mark, off the stick of McKinnon. Saved at the line there by Byram, albeit briefly, before the Jackets are able to clear, and it's Andrew Peak who dumps it deep.
Yeah, with Makar out, the 20-year-old Byram gets the duty of running the power play in that top unit. A rookie.
This is Jost now. Down the left wing and across the line. Jost from the left wing corner. Walks in front. Tried to tuck home a backhand, but Korpisalo was there on the short side. Up high. That's Girard. Deals it onto the right wing. Puck sent back to Girard. Quick shot off the blocker of Korpisalo. Gathered right back up here by the Avalanche. Girard now moves in. It's off his skate and out of the zone. See the time remaining in the first power play of the evening going Colorado's way. Korpisalo with a couple of big stops. Now Corrali tried to throw it back to the point. It's cut off. Jost across the line. Jost taken wide by Gavrikov. Jost tried to feed the point. It went between the two high players and all the way back into Colorado territory. It's the final seconds in the Laine penalty. Come off the clock. Jack Johnson now. Johnson will drop it there. Landeskog scoots through. Right back for Jack Johnson. Pass off the mark. Jackets clear. And four shots for Colorado, but they failed to score.
Yeah, really nice job by the Blue Jackets. Keeping the puck out of the zone, and Korpisalo with some big saves.
McKinnon a quick pass there. And Comper's shot was deflected wide. Jake Bean along the right wing board. He'll send it over the stick of Johnson. It's Johnson and Johnson, the defensive pairing. Eric
And of course, Jack. Eric scored the game-winning goal against the Wild in their last start. His first goal, Jody, in 603 days.
Yeah, he's a player that has had a lot of injuries, and there was a moment where they didn't even know if he was going to play hockey again. And the excitement and just the pure joy he had from that goal, scoring at home in front of his fans. It was quite the press conference the other night.
I bet. Right wing. Jackets clear the zone. Nyquist bangs it off the wall. Loose puck gathered up and shoveled into the zone by Vigna. Reaching for it there was Pete. Played up high. Looked around the wall there by Ryan Murray. And another familiar face wearing jersey number 28. From the corner. Walking out. Quick shot. Korpisalo has it. And he will hold.
Well, quick start. And you got to be ready for this one because the pace that the Avalanche play with. And to give them a power play early, you better be into it. And the Blue Jackets are. You can see this, though. Too much time and space on the outside. It looked like Texier actually got caught up in the middle of the ice on that entry. And that allowed all that time and space down the wing. That was on the power play for Jost. There he is. Carlson just couldn't recover. Their nice job, though, getting that stick on the puck at the last second. Jonas Korpisalo ready for this one, isn't he?
He sure is. Looks sharp. Second consecutive start. He's earned it based on his performance against the Devils. First time this season he's played in back-to-back games.
Texier just took a bit of a high hit there at the line. He's going to go right off.
Avalanche now into Columbus territory. Poke check there. Knocked away. And then the puck fired over the glass. And on the deflection, we'll get a faceoff.
Well, Brad Larsen, head coach of the Columbus Blue Jackets, played for the Colorado Avalanche. Credits his time here playing with a bunch of Hall of Famers and just watching and being a great teammate of those guys. Joe Sakic, Rob Blake, Peter Forsberg, and Jared Bednar, the bench boss of the Colorado Avalanche. Lots of admiration between both. They coached together. Brad actually hired Bednar in the minor leagues. Bednar has done a good job here with the Colorado Avalanche.
Avalanche win the draw. Korpisalo standing tall. Puck knocked down. Shoveled on to Compton across the line. He'll backhand it deep. Landeskog comes up with it. Line A chasing. Landeskog. Avalanche captain. Will deal. Girard comes off the point. One-time Nashville Predator. Gavrikov with the steal. Nice play defensively there. Below the goal line. Bayreuther, jersey number 5, playing his first game of the season. Called up. And joining the team on the road trip. Quick shot there. Johansson able to make the stop. The Avalanche clear. It'll be an icing call. And back into Colorado territory.
Yeah, Landeskog quickly cleared that puck off the rebound. Voracek, Laine and company get their first shift of the game under their belt after that quick shift where they took a penalty right away on McKinnon. That was, you see Voracek there always talking details, other options, maybe something he sees with Boone Jenner. How about Boone the other night, that goal to tie things up. Then they get the 5-on-3 penalty kill, which was remarkable to get the extra point. I mean, that was quite a night. A night you can rally around.
For sure.
New Jersey.
Nice to see Voracek, albeit the game-deciding goal in the shootout. Getting on the board, still looking for his first goal since returning to the Blue Jackets this season. It'll come. Can't think of a better night than tonight. Here's Sillinger off the wall. Jack Johnson able to clear. Jost tries to squeeze through along the wall. Another penalty upcoming here to the Blue Jackets. And interference is the call. Werenski's headed off.
Yeah, Werenski wants to play up on this puck. And as he does, the puck bounces away from Sillinger right there. You see Werenski's in a spot where he's trying to backhand that deep, but the perseverance and the play on the puck forces Zach to make a play there on Jost, and that brings out the top unit again for the Avalanche. Just over 5 minutes into this game, they're going to get their second look.
Had 4 shots on the previous power play. You don't want to give these guys too much of an opportunity, even though they've struggled on the power play out of the gate. And Korpisalo able to see that despite the screen as Byron fired it right on the net. And that is Byron with the puck back in Colorado territory. He will lead the rush up. Landeskog gets it right back across the line. Looks knocked down there was Kadri, able to knock the puck down, but Byron's got to scoop it back up.
You've seen Byron a couple times late on that blue line. Those forwards are looking to bump it back to the lone D-man. He's just a little bit off on those reads.
Again, moving up. Normally that spot held by Makar. Byron. MacKinnon with a quick feed and moving laterally to make a stop once again was Korpisalo. He is extremely sharp here in the early going.
He's moving well, isn't he?
He sure is. Jacket shorthanded into the zone. Attempted shot there by Robinson is knocked down. Kauf, former first round pick, jersey number 61 on the second unit here. Kiefer Sherwood, jersey number 44, called up for this one. Shorthanded, Jackets move in. Nyquist, a little spinorama. Daniel Hudson able to make the stick save. Another attempt by the Blue Jackets. This one by Texier. 30 seconds left on the power play. Jackets with maybe the best two opportunities.
Yeah, now they're controlling that puck. And here they're going to get a forecheck by Corrali.
Johansson heels it to the wall. Girard looks off Jost. Walks to the line. Drops it back. Jost now trying to scoot through. Off the wall, Jackets clear. And the penalty is over. One shot on the second manpower advantage. Werenski has stepped back on the ice. And there's Laine reaching for it. Can't make the play. Jake Voracek for the Blue Jackets. Puts the brakes on at the line. Deals it back. Now a right wing feed for Jenner. He'll send it the rest of the way. Eric Johnson from behind the net for Colorado. Johnson paired with Ryan Murray currently. Murray waits in the near corner. Eric Johnson feeds the puck ahead. Avalanche here, move up ice. It's McDonald who dumps in. Korpisalo way out of the net. Able to throw it around the wall. Stepping up now McDermott. Jackets tried to chop it out of the zone. Roslovic with a second effort, could not clear. Picked up on the right wing boards. And it sails high with Darren Helm camped in front, the former Red Wing. Voracek. Puck is kept in here by Comfort. First line over the boards for Colorado. Roslovic down the right wing to center. Jack Roslovic will slide it deep. Avalanche, Girard. Right wing. In deep there is Comfort. Takes a hit there from Bayreuther. Byron steps up. Puck thrown off into the corner. Bayreuther. On for Chinikov. Chinikov tried to feed it ahead and went the length of the ice, and icing waved off. Great burst of speed shown there by Gregory Hoffman to negate the icing. Colorado called for icing.
Colorado threw out MacKinnon against Hoffman. Well, how about that save? That got deflected late and he got that right pad on it. Talk about locked in. And then Nyquist with the spinorama.
Up high, Nyquist dancing away. Drops it there for Jake Bean. Bean sends it towards the net. Knocked out in front. The Jackets. Bjorkstrand was a guy who knocked it down and then tried to fire the biscuit. Nyquist again. Sillinger camped in front. Sillinger at the side of the net tried to jam it home. Landeskog off the wall. Bouncing puck played by Werenski as he's able to clear the zone. Oh, slipping and falling there was Jake Bean, but play call. 10:20 left, opening period. The Avalanche and the Blue Jackets here in Denver, scoreless.
Inside the locker room with all the players sitting there, that he was their captain. I watched every player's face. The eyes were big, the smiles were there. I saw nothing but teeth. They were just smiling. And that's respect from the team. He has a respect for the team, for the franchise, for the game, for the city. It's a good choice.
And that was your Taco Bell take. John Davidson, president of hockey operations, back with the Blue Jackets. Just in admiration of this young man. And there's not a team in the National Hockey League that wouldn't want to have Boone Jenner. You can't teach what he's got, the intangibles, the leadership. And just how about him just taking that game the other night?
Outstanding effort. Up.
So that's Boone Jenner.
Unassisted, incredible effort goal. And not where Boone normally scores his goals from. Just to show he's got the skill from up high as well. Texier, quite an endorsement for Boone, but deservedly so. In front, Jackets tried to feed it towards the net. Texier was tied up here along the wall. On the breakout, puck is dumped deep. Second line out here, and play called. And another icing call against the Avalanche.
This is Adele Technologies in control. This is the other night, that goal by Boone Jenner. Talked about it. See what he does tonight. He's on the dot right now.
Fifth goal to lead the Blue Jackets, 5-8. Well ahead of the pace when he scored 30 goals. Ice time is up, better than 3 minutes a game.
You watch him in a game, he's always talking to the linesman. He says there's a little bit of an advantage sometimes just with the communication, because the way each one drops the puck a little bit differently.
Kadri tried to walk in after taking the feed, but the Jackets are there defending along the wall. O'Connor, and it turned aside by Korpisalo. In front again, O'Connor could not reach the puck as the Jackets defensively able to clear. They walk it out to center, and Laine with it, and called him an on and off side at the offensive blue line. 9:14 left, opening period. Colorado, Columbus. No scores. Kadri tries to walk in.
Altitude, right? I asked Brad Larson about it yesterday after practice. He said it's a real thing. He worked out on Monday and he said he felt horrible. He said, look, as you look at the pictures of our intrepid expedition up to the top of Pikes Peak, but Brad Larson said, look, you got to keep the shift short here, because when you get to this elevation, it's real, and you can't be chasing the game when you're in this high altitude. He said it's a real thing. Those guys right there, though, I can tell you, all handled it beautifully, guys.
Play underway. Andrew Peak fails to clear the zone. Second effort, Jackets do in fact get it out. Hoffman chipped ahead. Avalanche are there defending. Helm tried to send it in. Murray sends it cross ice there for McDermott. Off a stick, McDermott will play it again. Roslovic had a stick on it and sends it back. Jackets go D to D. Less than 9 to go. Roslovic now from center. Across the line. Jack Roslovic trying to cut to the net. Fires a sharp angle shot. And Johansson making the glove save and holds.
Roslovic not happy with his game whatsoever. -3 the last two games. He's a center iceman who likes to play, make the plays, and there. One of the great plays that has happened so far in this game as Roslovic attacks that outside. Not a lot of shots so far, a couple on the outside. But I like the way he picks up that puck with authority and gets to the neutral zone. Fast start to this exciting game.
How about young Sillinger? Matched up a few times here in this opening period against the top line. Landeskog steps in to win the faceoff.
Yeah, he was jacked up about that. Pretty cool, he's in his words. Pretty cool to play against McKinnon tonight.
Moving up in the lineup.
He's earned it.
Yes, he has.
Putting a lot of pucks on net. He's working on his shot. Now, I was talking with Kenny McCutton about his shot. And Kenny wants him not to shoot off his left foot. He says when you set up on your left foot as a left-handed shooter, it shows the goalie that you're going to shoot. Try to shoot off that right foot. And he showed him examples of practice, some tape with him. So something he's working on, because he is getting that, those opportunities, but he just needs to change it a little bit to try to beat the goalies in the National Hockey League. So a lot of details. You see him there on the dot, pointing at the stick of the opposition there. And the faceoff. A lot goes into this, and these guys spent a lot of time in practice working on it. Nice job by Bjorkstrand.
Nyquist won the draw.
Yeah.
And now Nyquist in a foot race here. Does not give up on it. That's Sherwood, keeper Sherwood, called up for this game.
Yeah,
with all the injuries.
Walk in the building with his buddy Jack Rosselbeck. Two sharp dressed men from Columbus, Ohio.
Former AAA Blue Jackets. Isn't that great?
Yeah, it really is.
7:50 left.
Bednar was asked why Kiefer was called up from their farm team. He said he's on fire down there.
Didn't score last night, but he has been red hot.
7 goals in 8 games down there. It's only an hour away from here. Their American Hockey League affiliate, Colorado Eagles. And his brother Cole was with the Blue Jackets. Now he's in the Ottawa system, but Kiefer, remember, played in Anaheim and signed here as a free agent this year. Went to college at Miami of Ohio and part of a wonderful organization here, getting an opportunity with all those injuries.
Right point. Drop, long shot, could not get through to Corposalo. Here, Byram just sent it wide in a race for the puck. Robinson with that speed. Eric Robinson trying to get to it. Girard defending. Oh, that puck was deflected right through the goal mark. Byram gets it to McKinnon. Comfort, left wing, knocked down, getting an opportunity without Mikko Rantanen to move up onto that top line. Number of the players, remember this is a home and home series. They'll be at Nationwide Saturday. Many of the players that are injured tonight could potentially be back playing Saturday, including Makar.
That's right. You know, that's one thing about injury, right? You get quick opportunities. You got to take advantage of them. And, you know, these teams with these superstars, you know, remember Pittsburgh, when Malkin or Crosby are out, either one of them, that's still, they rise to the occasion. That's what superstars usually do. And that's why the Blue Jackets need to do what they've done so far. You can see McKinnon, they've had two power plays. He's getting a little bit frustrated. The Blue Jackets are crowding him in the defensive zone, not letting him wind it up.
Line A now. Peak. With a left wing pass off his stick. Avalanche pick it up. Ryan Murray. Johnson back to Murray. This is Kadri stepping in. Nazem Kadri with a shot. They really missed him, Jody, in the playoffs last year. Got that 8-game suspension. They beat St. Louis 4 straight, but then lost 4 straight in the second round despite winning the President's Trophy. Vegas beating them. Here's a shot by McDermott, and it's sent wide. Now Jenner.
Yeah, Kadri's one of those players, hard to play against. Good on faceoffs.
Jenner with a backhand attempt. Stick was down from Johansson.
And he walks the line. Sometimes he does cross it, though. That's one of his things he's getting a reputation for now, and something he's got to make a really good effort to get out of his game, especially in those playoffs.
Rolling puck settled down by Roslovic. Tried to feed it ahead there. Chinikov started bursting up that wing but could not get a stick on it. Jack Johnson now able to keep it in. Tosses it off into the corner. Bayreuther defending. Chinikov back to help out his defenseman. Rims it around the wall. Saved there by Byram. And he'll throw it back behind the net. Jost to the point. D to D. Byram to pick it up. Switched up the defensive bearings. We have the Avalanche with less than 5 to go now in the scoreless first period. Puck sent in front and then sent immediately wide. Jost tried to get a stick on it. Up high, it's saved at the line. Byram right out of the stick of the Blue Jackets. Bayreuther. Now Roslovic, who had one of the better scoring chances for the Jackets in this opening period.
I like his play here too. He was going to dump the puck in, but instead he curls back, keep possession for the Blue Jackets. Now get off the ice and let these fresh guys come out. Try to get in the zone.
McDermott denying the Jackets entry there. Now picked up onside here by Nyquist. Just Nyquist trying to fight off McDermott. Ryan Murray moves it up the wall. Werenski is there. off the point, Jake Dean. Sherwood hands it right here to Sillinger, and a quick wrist shot. Just wide. He looks short side. Out of the zone. Avalanche. Marinsky defending. That's Sherwood. Back out of Bjorkstrand. Gerard got a stick on it. Here's McKinnon. McKinnon dancing. Looks. Moving in. Eric Johnson. Johnson now. Lost his stick, looking for a penalty to be called.
No call. Broke his stick, too. I think he broke it on the shot.
Here's Bjorkstrand, and a glove stop by Johansson. Off the stick of Oliver Bjorkstrand. 3:32 remaining. End-to-end action here. Still no score.
That shot off the right foot. Just talking about that, trying to disguise the shot. So what he did there, if we could see it again, he tries to attack that middle of the ice, and instead of getting on his left foot, stays on his right foot.
So now the faceoff to the left of the Avalanche net. Landeskog and Boone Jenner. Jenner cleanly wins the draw. Bayreuther. To get it to Voracek, hopped over his stick. Jenner from the far side. Gerard taps it away. And here comes McKinnon. Dances through and across the line. Tried to walk around Laine, who was there defending.
He did a pretty good job for a forward backing up there with Nate McKinnon coming down.
Sure did. Comfort. On to Gerard. All kinds of traffic in front, and it's wristed wide of the net. Puck thrown to the point by Eric Johnson. Now Landeskog, ridden off on the play. Comes up high here to Gerard. They're tied to feed it ahead. Landeskog, top of the circle. Quick shot, Jackets block that. And the puck sails all the way to the Colorado line. Ronta unable to get anywhere. Kadri drops it back, looks for the return feed. Byram will dump in. Korpisalo out of the net to trap it, seeing the Avalanche come quickly. Right wing, Eric Robinson. Corrali across the line. Moves away from Jack Johnson. Byram is there, far side of the ice. Avalanche dump behind. Corrali protects that puck. He thought about coming in. Retreating to that right point. Corrali. Corrali, Texier. Texier pressured, turns, fires, and it's off the blocker of Johansson. Jack Johnson in the line. Nice effort there, but Andrew Peak unable to keep it in. Jackets dump it back, and they'll change up here, as do the Avalanche with less than two to go. Cross ice, Jost steps in. Werenski defending. Jost trying to protect that puck, went down to his knees, still with it. Jost sends it cross ice. Shot towards the net by Murray. Deflected, but right up into the glove of Korpisalo. We pause now for this word from Romeo's Pizza.
At Romeo's, we believe everyone deserves great pizza. Order online now and get up to $7 off at romeospizza.com.
Korpisalo just looks so strong and confident there. Think about this. I mean, he finally gets to start two games, you know, prepare. Got here Sunday night after the New Jersey game, a day off, practice yesterday, and here's a guy that looks extremely locked in. 12 shots, he's got faced a couple of the power plays. One shot deflected out high, just total focus and flexibility and athleticism to make the save. And now, you know, you can tell that the team in front of him is feeding off of that.
Allen. If you notice late, that first power play, four quality scoring chances and shots. And Korpisalo turned all four aside. A little more than a minute left here now. Johnson. Right wing. Landeskog with McKinnon. McKinnon just wants to go. You can just see it. Less than a minute to go here in the period. Jackets pick it up. Down the wing. Nyquist drops it there. Heads up play. In front. Kick save and a beauty there. The left pad of Johansson. Meantime, at the other end, it's Kadri trying to walk around Werenski, who's going to have no part of that. End-to-end action. What a glorious scoring chance for the Jackets there. Johansson with a big stop. Less than 30 seconds left. Avalanche come again. Denied entry. They had to clear and walk back in. Sillinger just drops it back. Jackets go D to D. Bayreuther now. Puck is tipped and not out. Kept in by Sherwood. Far side of the ice, Laine. Laine turning away from traffic. Gets it back here to Bayreuther. Bouncing puck rolls into Colorado's end. Centering pass, and there's the horn to end an entertaining but scoreless first period. Shots 12-10 favoring the Avalanche.
Great period by the Blue Jackets. Textbook. You wanted to frustrate. And how about Cole Sillinger below the goal line there on Nate MacKinnon? Makes the play, gets in his way and stops him up. Now, as he makes his way up the ice, there he is again. The option on the back door. So centerman, defensive responsibility down there with Nate MacKinnon. And then he gets up into play and almost tucks one past Johansson. So for the Blue Jackets, weathered the storm on the power play. Their goaltender played remarkable, but the details, they took care of them.
Two power plays in the opening period. Both went to Colorado. The Avalanche out shooting the Blue Jackets 12-10. But after 20, no score. We step aside. We will head back to the studio. Jean-Luc Grandpierre and Brian Gieselslaw standing by after the opening period here in Denver. Columbus Blue Jackets hockey brought to you by IGS Energy. Every good choice adds up to a better world. Go green for good at IGS.com. And by Ohio Health, the official healthcare provider of your Columbus Blue Jackets.
Back in Denver, the Jackets and Avs have played 20 minutes. No score from Bell Arena, the third and final stop for the Jackets on this first real road trip of the season. Welcome back inside. Brian Gieselslaw, Jean-Luc Grandpierre. At times, the Jackets didn't counter the Avs' speed all that well, but Jonas Korpisalo did help counter those early power plays.
Yes, he did. And 42 seconds in, stick penalty by Patrick Laine, and that's what happened when you don't move your feet. And we talked about it. Don't get caught up by their speed, right. And it didn't take too long. So Korpisalo with some big save. Four shots on the power play for the Avalanche, and he keeps the Blue Jackets in that game. And I think after that second penalty to Zach Werenski, I think things settled down a little bit. But yes, for the Blue Jacket, not the ideal start with two penalties.
That's all right. Unscathed so far. One of the killers, Vladislav Gavrikov, back at the rink now with Mets.
Well, Vlad, you and I were just talking, a couple big kills. How did that help you get into that period?
Well, of course, it's stays 0-0 for us, so it's a good sign. Yeah, big two kills, like you said, for us, it's just gave us an energy, and we should start from there.
You know what kind of speed this Colorado team has. How can you guys negate their speed a little bit?
Well, you have to expect, like, top line, it's they are coming just all the time, so you got to be careful with that. Just be patient, play like defense first, and after that try to attack.
Vlad, how much do you enjoy that kind of challenge?
Well, it's a good opportunity for us. I like the team, I like how we prepare, so we'll see what's happened, but I'm definitely like it.
Thanks for this. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Hey, Jackets fans. If you're looking for an entertaining night out with your friends, family, or coworkers, bring your group of 10 or more to a Jackets home game. Go to bluejackets.com/groups to learn more. Still looking for that first strike against the Avs in Denver. Scoreless first for Colorado and Columbus.
With DirecTV Stream, I can get live TV and on demand.
Down back in Denver for the Jackets and Avs. Second period action still ahead. Just a few minutes, but the Jackets, JL, playing tonight without Max Domi on the COVID protocol list. Unfortunately, that's a problem league-wide.
Yes, it is, and especially with Pittsburgh. Crosby, Doomland this time. Earlier this year was Letang, then Jake Gensel, Jeff Carter, Tristan Jarry. So, yes, unfortunately, these two players right now are, you know, away from the team. So we have it here in Columbus with Max Domi, and it's going around the league.
Yeah. The Metro right now so competitive, though, as the Jackets try to pick up 2 points tonight on the road in Denver. More when we come back after this.
Tossed.
Buffalo.
Sauced.
Hot honey.
Flipped.
Tyler.com. And by Jets, the best Detroit-style pizza on the planet. Well, Jean-Luc, they've played 20 minutes so far in Denver. Four of that on the penalty kill for the Jackets and Jonas Korpisalo.
Yes, and they attacked on the power play. That was Jost early on. This time it's Samuel Girard with a nice shot. A little rebound here, and then this one, Bowen Byron, deflected shot in front. And then the last one, beautiful play from McKinnon to Landeskog. And solid save by Korpisalo. He's solid. He's making it look easy, and that's a good thing right now. For the Blue Jackets, though, rest the guy up a little bit. Let's play a little bit of offense this period.
Play a little bit of offense, and so you, yes, certainly Jonas Korpisalo has been a big part of the solution of the first for the Jackets, but they did push back. There was an adjustment period to the speed. That'll probably continue throughout the game to a certain degree, but they were able to push back and able to create some scoring opportunities.
Yes, and the big thing when you play a team with that much speed is the separation between your forwards and your defensemen, yeah, because when the McKinnons of this world see open ice, they take advantage of it, and it becomes really hard for the defensemen to handle that speed. So the closer you can be together as a group of five, the less room there is for these guys to skate around. So it's a little bit of a challenge when, yeah, you try to forecheck, but try to stay grouped a little bit better.
Yeah. Anything you noticed so far from the new players in the Jackets lineup tonight, that being Chinakhov or Gavin Bayreuther, anything stand out?
I've noticed Bayreuther, and he's, yeah, playing a lot of minutes already. We talked about it. He's going to, mm-hmm, be in the 18 to 20, and he's already got, I think, 7.5 minutes, actually. Yeah, 7 minutes already, just in the first period. So he's well on his way to 20.
Yeah. Well, if you're Brad Larsen of the Jackets, consider the first period a win, because the two power plays, no score for Colorado. Now regroup and come back in the second. We send you back to Rims. Jody and Metz coming up next.
Only Wendy serves a better
bread. Arena, no score after 20. Jeff River, Jody Shelley rejoining you here. And Jody, quick thought on the first.
Jonas Korpisalo was outstanding. Gavrikov, solid plays down there in the defensive zone. The penalty kill did a great job, and the Blue Jackets started to get their offensive zone chances.
All right, let's take a look at the nationwide telestrator, shall we?
Yeah, we're going to focus in on the last play there for the Cole Sillinger line, and specifically Cole. And there he is in the corner, below the goal line, separating McKinnon. You can see him down there taking care of that detail. The center iceman taking responsibility, really stopping McKinnon up. Now he sees the pucks on the wall and he gets his legs moving. You can see over there Bjorkstrand now makes a wonderful play there to get that puck in motion forward, and now Sillinger is back in the play on the right side of your screen. Oh, what an opportunity, but it starts in the D zone, and especially when you're out there against one of the best skaters and playmakers in the world in McKinnon, this 18-year-old kid. Those are the things that the coaching staff marvels about, and his teammates, when they say he's mature, when they say he gets it. It's that detail defensively to stop up Nate McKinnon and then follow it up with an offensive zone chance. Right now he's nose-to-nose with Gabriel Landeskog. Looks pretty comfortable, doesn't he?
Sure does.
Chewing on that mouth guard.
Seeing a little more ice time in that opening period, deservedly so. So we expect to see him even more so here as we get set for second period play. And he wins the draw. Great work. Not intimidated whatsoever. Mature beyond his years as the puck is dumped in. And it's Sillinger to pick it up with a quick shot right off the pad. Last shot of the opening period. First shot of the second off the stick of 18-year-old Cole Sillinger. There it's backhanded ahead. Landeskog from the corner. Knocked down by Werenski. Picked up by Kadri. In the slot. Quick shot scores! Logan O'Connor handed the puck in the slot. And it's 1-0.
Blue Jackets start quick. The first 21 seconds, they're down in the offensive zone. And then back come the Avalanche. And Landeskog, really impressive on the forecheck. He's the one who pursued the puck early. You can see he's checking his shoulder, and as he goes down, that play keeps the puck alive, and now here comes O'Connor. And he takes that shot that looks like it goes off the stick of the Blue Jackets. That's the shot. You can see Jonas Korpisalo. He's playing their percentages there. And that one just skims off the crossbar and into the back of the net.
First goal for O'Connor. 1-0. Colorado. Jackets tried to feed the point. Broken up. Here come the Avalanche. O'Connor had it chipped away off the stick of Gavrikov. Blue Jackets dump in deep. Johnson is bumped behind the net. Roslovic there with Gregory Hoffman. Loose puck, Roslovic. He'll send it up high. Gavrikov with a quick shot. Kadri and Landeskog draw the assist. 32 seconds into the second period. Jackets, a long line change. And it's O'Connor who will sweep it off into the corner. The Avalanche trying to catch the Jackets on that line change. From deep in Columbus territory, Darren Helm steps away, throws it up high from the corner. Kaut to the near side. Girard had stepped up. He was backed up there by Helm, able to keep it in. Jost with the attempted pass, broken up by the Blue Jackets. Jenner now circles his own net, sends it out of the zone. Waiting there is Voracek onside. Jake away from Girard. Laine up high. Jackets go D to D. Werenski looks in that slot for Laine. Rolled off his stick. Played there by Darren Helm. Kaut unable to get a stick on it. And icing is the call against the Avalanche.
Gavrikov having a very nice game. Led the Blue Jackets in ice time with 8 minutes in that first period. And here he is off the wall. See that puck. A couple chances to get deflected. Look at him, he's smiling. Just having a good time, this guy.
Enjoying always
the in-house entertainment on the big screen at Ball Arena.
He's got just a great personality.
Oh, he does, yeah.
And very engaging. Nyquist attempted shot knocked down. Kaut will throw it behind the net. Avalanche have it. Outlet for Jost. Werenski steps up on him. Able to keep it in. Reaching forward is Nyquist. Sillinger camped in front of the net. Werenski right there along with him will now move to that half wall. He's backed up by Bjorkstrand. Werenski on to Jake Bean. Bean looking for some open ice. Werenski to pick it up down that right side. Stick save Johansson. Kaut took an awful spill behind the net. He's in some difficulties. Makes his way back to the Colorado bench. And icing is the call here against the Blue Jackets. Corrali tried to beat it. Looks over his shoulder at the official.
Let's go back to that goal by the Colorado Avalanche O'Connor. You can see Nyquist just takes a swipe at it. Misses the stick on stick. And then Nyquist reacted, kind of looking to the ceiling. He was there. He was in the right spot. It was a quick pass to the middle. Just missed on that play. And that happens. So good veteran Nyquist. That's how close the details are, too. I mean, you're talking about inches there from negating or at least getting a piece of that puck. Good start. It was a good shift for that line, too, Jeff. We were noticing their play to start the second period.
They won the faceoff. Sillinger over Landeskog. They moved down the ice. And then quickly in transition, the Avalanche move up. And O'Connor finds the back of the net for his first and a 1-0 Colorado lead here early on in the second period. Here come the Avalanche again across the line. Puck will hop over the stick there of Mitka and backhanded back where McDermott will play it. Eric Robinson on the forecheck. Avalanche up the left wing out to center. Sillinger with a hit right there at the Columbus bench. Avalanche across the line and Byram denied there by Jonas. I guess I can't call him Jonas. We've got to stick with Korpisalo because Jonas is at the other end of the ice, too, and Johansson. Here's McKinnon. In and across the line. Drops it there. Landeskog turns a long shot by Johnson. And Korpisalo will make the stop.
Yeah, he could see it the entire way. Thanks to Gabriel Carlson in front. Forecheck for the Blue Jackets. F1 is in there strong. Where's F2?
Texier's got to jump over there a little quicker. That little bit of extra time allows the Avalanche to exit the zone. And when you get Robinson going so fast, you got to have your motor going too. And you can see that nice shot lane opened up for Jonas Korpisalo. Appreciates that.
Comper won the draw over Jenner. Long shot there by McKinnon. Blocked. Here come the Jackets. Nyquist. There's Jenner and Bjorkstrand. Nyquist with a shot off the glove, the outside of the glove there of Johansson. And now the Avalanche move up ice. This is McKinnon. Through and across the line. He's got Comper on the wing. Comper with a sharp angle shot turned away. Left point. On here for Johnson. Eric Johnson moving in. Johnson at the goal line. Johnson dishing. McKinnon comes out of the corner. Slides it into the slot. Jackets are there to defend. And it's Bjorkstrand. Across the line. Puck rolls free to Johnson, who hands to Girard. Approaching the 5-minute mark. Here at period number two. Avalanche now, full speed across the line. This is Kadri. He'll throw it off into the corner. Trying to walk out here is Renta. Renta to the point, long shot, blocked. Hoffman tried to take that Chinikov feed, but thwarted in that attempt. From a sharp angle off a skate, bouncing puck. Played. Chinikov, then Hoffman. Avalanche come up with it. Ranta. They drop it back. Avalanche go D to D.
You got Sillinger coming out with Voracek and Laine.
Now Jenner had taken a shift previously.
Well, he took the draw, and Brad Larson told him to stay out there. He was heading to the bench. And a moment to change things up.
Sillinger from a sharp angle send it off the side of the net. We saw these three together in training camp.
Yeah.
A couple preseason games.
Well, they tried Cole with everyone.
Didn't look out of place with these guys either.
You got to test them, right?
Exactly. And here he is tonight. Right there with the big boys. Voracek and Laine just peeled off and headed to the bench. Now Voracek across the line. No, he'll hold up. Gavrikov with it. He'll dump. Johnson cuts it off. Corrali tried to play the puck. Down the wing, out to center. Werenski denying the Avalanche entry into Columbus territory. Corrali, Texier, and Robinson. The feed ahead. Jake Bean in off the point. Byram gets a piece of him. Texier was in the slot. Puck was bouncing. Corrali knocking down the Avalanche player. That was a good stick play. Crowd again looking for a penalty to be called. A lot of officials at the building.
Well, looked like he was going to get a break. But perfect play by Corrali to get the stick on stick.
Here from the point. Now Voracek. Werenski from a sharp angle, and they're all over the officials here. Time for the Hyundai drive to the net.
We didn't hear that last year in the fabricated noise, did we? The crowd noise, that chant we just heard from the fans. That's the block in the defensive zone, and then the attack. Nice details by the Blue Jackets.
12:59 left, second period, 1-0.
Time for the CarShield protection play, and it's Corrali protecting. Yeah, I like the non-call there. it could have gone either way. What the heck? Boone Jenner now between Bjorkstrand and Nyquist. Boone does a great job on the dots. There's a lot of communicating with Sean Corrali. This is on the left side for Boone, his strong side. Corrali's trying to get better on the right side and says when he's on the right, he just goes for the stick of the opposition, and it's surprised sometimes that he knocks the stick out of the other centerman's hands. But getting some tips from Boone.
Well, Boone won that one.
Yeah. He just goes straight power, usually to the back end, but he's got a couple tricks on the right side.
Came in tonight better than 60% in faceoff circles. Werenski, quick shot, juggled, but Johansson is there in the blue paint to hold on the first little scrum of the night.
Well, Jenner looked like he's playing D there and trying to move the player out in front of
his net, but he's actually moving the play out in front of his own net.
It's Landeskog, captain on captain.
Werenski up in the play, and they've talked to Zach about this year. You know, it's different. Doesn't have Seth Jones, who's got to try to find the trust with the new D partner, Bean, and in the system. When do you go? When do you not go? And seamlessly, the past 5 years, it's been just no hesitation. So he's got two goals on the year. He likes to score. He wants to do more. But it's a realistic thing. He's defending better because he's really has that conscious effort. It's not the, you know, that comforting presence next to him. So good to see him up on the play there. I'm sure that'll develop as the season goes on. There's Cole.
He had a conversation with Bayreuther. He's really taking charge here prior to puck drop. Oh. And the puck is tipped there by Kadri. Jackets back. Line A tosses to the far side. Sillinger slides it across for Gavrikov. Quick feed. Voracek, he's got Line A with him. Oh, Line A was set for the one-timer and a poke check there by Eric Johnson. Just sent that puck away. Right idea. Here come the Avalanche. Kadri flips a backhand. O'Connor denied the pad save of Korpisalo. Line A. On to Sillinger. Voracek waits on the right wing, holds the line, takes the pass there. Look for Line A, broken up by Sherwood. Sherwood down the off wing. Kiefer Sherwood with a shot, that's deflected.
Back to back cross ice passes. Voracek to Line A, got picked off there. Coming up with nothing. That line needs to think now to get pucks on the net and try to crash.
Voracek into the zone. Sillinger will peel off. Voracek, there's the hardest hit on him, and it was the referee. Across the line.
I think McDermott had something to do with it. 6'6", breezed by a pair.
There along the wall. Gregory Hoffman. Shot by Jost towards the net. It went wide. Peak. Sends it off the wall to center. Chinnikov redirects it right on the net. Bouncing puck to center. Shift ahead, Werenski. Hoffman with Chinnikov. Hoffman cuts around the defense. Fires a shot and a glove save by Johansson. Burst of speed. Quality shot there.
Yeah, the crowd with a nice ovation for their goaltender, Johansson. And he's another big goalie, 6'5". Here's Voracek. The initial play. How about that play by Eric Johnson to knock it out of the air? Here's Hoffman with speed around the big McDermott. Good speed, nice jump on that puck in the neutral zone. But how about Zach Werenski knocked it out of the air? Made the play in the neutral zone to just bat it out of the air up to Hoffman. Seems like that happens so much more now.
Great hand-eye coordination for sure. Hoffman left McDermott in the dust there. Here, Nyquist, Girard defending. Centering pass, Bjorkstrand. Jenner sets the screen in front of Johansson. Werenski floats one in, look for that redirect in front. It went off Girard. Jenner right there on top of Johansson. Colorado netminder. Bjorkstrand takes a hard hit along the wall there from Landeskog. No damage done, gets right back on his feet.
His face was right up against the glass.
Bjorkstrand tried to play the puck there. Landeskog feeds it ahead. Girard, left wing, quick shot. McKinnon right in on top of Korpisalo, tried to redirect that one right from the blue paint. We've passed the 10-minute mark here. The second period is Landeskog deals it on the wing. There's a shot by Byram. Turned away. Rolling puck, chopped ahead. Avalanche save it up high. Down the right wing. Backhanded there. Johnson and Johnson on the blue line. Jack and Eric. Here's Texier now, trying to walk in. Right pad there on Johansson, and then Texier takes a hit from Jack Johnson to the delight of the crowd. Gavrikov. Up the middle, Eric Robinson trying to scoop behind the defense there. Backhanded ahead, Gavrikov steps up. able to knock that puck down. Texier with a hit. Eric Robinson will dump it behind the net. Ryan Murray there, up the left wing boards. On ahead here on the wing for Eric Robinson. Corrali finishing a check behind the Colorado net. Rolling puck back out to center. Jackets gain the zone once more. Robinson feeds Texier. Texier threw it right back in front, and it sails all the way back into the Columbus end. Gabriel Carlson looking for Sillinger deep in the zone. Voracek leaving it right there for Laine with a drive. Carlson. Voracek reaching for it. There is Landeskog. Gabriel Landeskog. MacKinnon circles and away from Laine. Centering pass, MacKinnon walking in, fires a shot. Right there is Korpisalo to turn it away. Left point, on to Girard. Drops it up high to Landeskog. Gabriel Carlson will pick it up. Sillinger burst out of the zone. Laine across the line. Sillinger set up, takes it, fires, shot blocked. Back the other way. Here's Kadri across the line. Kadri in, centers a pass, shoots and scores. Does Byram. It's 2-0.
Blue Jackets look like they had an offensive zone opportunity. And they did. And Jake Voracek sets it up with a pass to Sillinger. Just a little bit too late, and Colorado jumps all over it. Kadri with the pass to Byram. No chance for Jonas Korpisalo. There's Kadri on the two-on-one. Left-handed shot down the right side. Feeds it perfectly, and Byram picks it up on the bounce and puts it over Jonas Korpisalo, who was there, and he's not happy with himself. He thinks he should have had that puck. Bowen Byram on the board for his second.
Jackets, Bjorkstrand from a sharp angle just let it fly. Along the board, Jenner. Knocked down in Bjorkstrand. Trying to go high, stick side, and the puck caroms all the way back where it's gathered up by the Blue Jackets. Werenski will take the pass from Jake B. Werenski, right wing feed too far there for Jenner. Jack Johnson pressured. Jenner knocks it off his stick. Eric Johnson is there. Down the wing, Helm. Puck played by Korpisalo, high off the glass. Bjorkstrand able to come up with it. Saucers a backhand pass for Nyquist. Nyquist just dumps in. So Landeskog picking up the second assist. Kadri, the primary assist, and Landeskog's got 2 points, as does Kadri. Here moving in, there's a shot by O'Connor, who scored the first goal. Turned away. Shot down low and covered up. Bayreuther. And the Avalanche forward. As we step aside, no damage done.
On Yost. No, right. Sorry, right there. First one wasn't bad. So he sits for two. There he is. And then Jonas Korpisalo's reaction on that last goal. Take a look at what happens here. It's a pass across. Here's the shot. And see how it goes back towards him? He felt it. He was there. It was on the blocker. It's just the blocker was tilted sideways. That's why he wasn't happy. He felt like he should have had that puck.
Jonas has been outstanding here tonight, turning aside 20 of 22 shots. And now Jackets are on the kill for the third time. 0 for 2, 5 shots for Colorado with a manpower advantage. Byram, quick feed here for Kadri. Kadri down that right side. Olds gets it back to Byram. MacKinnon, touch pass. And Landeskog denied by the glove save.
Yeah, we watched MacKinnon this morning do power play practice, and you could hear him yelling at Kadri about where he was standing.
Right.
He demands a lot. He understands what's happening. He's processing the game so fast. He's got a lot of options here, and you can see how Peak is out on him, and he's got no real shot. So the play there is the bump to the middle. Nice option to Landeskog, who gets the first shot for the Avs power play.
Jackets control from the faceoff, find some room and dump it the length of the ice.
Nice muscle by Gavrikov there to make sure.
Aver, they're in the box. Colorado on the power play, and it's Byram out to center. He'll drop it back. Quick feed. McKinnon racing in. Kadri drops it back for Byram. Back for Kadri. Byram now walking the line. Kadri. Right circle. Floats a pass. One-timer there by McKinnon. Blocked. And oh, that one hurt. Peak back on his feet. Byram. Kadri, Byram, McKinnon waits, shot sent high and wide. Now Landeskog. One-timer there by McKinnon, off the shoulder, up into the glove. Korpisalo will hold with an Avalanche camp right in front. That's Kampfer, who's now hearing from Gavrikov.
Blue Jackets penalty kill. Wow, how about the work they've done as Andrew Peak limps to the bench and McKinnon's winding up. Oh, he got turned around. Ouch! Not much padding there. That's going to leave a mark. He's not going to... He's trying not to let anyone know that he's a little tender.
Ooh.
Fine, shake it off.
Kadri. Avalanche control for the faceoff. Byram fires. Save. Rebound in front. It's in the blue paint. They try to jam it home. And it's waved off. Waved off. The whistle blew before that puck crossed the line. And the referee... made that very clear.
Nice battle by Jonas Korpisalo and company, and Colorado wins the faceoff and sets up their play, and it's a long shot from Byram. And then the scramble ensues. It looks like they pushed Jonas in here. Jonas Korpisalo right there. Comper just pushed his pad in. They can't do that. Can't push the goalie in the net. Right there, excellent look at it. He was trying to sell it. Now they're showing it in-house here. The crowd is a good crowd here.
Official right in perfect position. Made the call immediately. Here's Kadri hanging on. Looks down low. Landeskog off a skate and wide. Tried to feed McKinnon there. Kadri back to Byram. These guys have been out there for the entire power play. Less than 30 seconds left now. Byram. Landeskog sets the screen. It's high and wide. And it caroms all the way back into the Avalanche zone, final 15. Byram waits, he'll backhand it deep. Far side of the ice, McKinnon. Can't get a stick on it. Gabriel Carlson is there for the Blue Jackets. Eric Robinson will bank it off the boards and clear the zone. Four shots for the second time on the power play.
Remarkable kill by the Blue Jackets. Remember that block by Peak. That was a big play in this game to keep it at 2-0.
Next goal is huge. The Jackets get it. They're right back in this one. There's plenty of time remaining.
And the saves by Jonas Korpisalo.
Outstanding. Robinson at the line. Trying to hang out of that puck. Three. Avalanche convert. Far side of the ice. Nyquist knocks it down. Girard defending. Nyquist fights him off. Away from Johnson. Puck up high. Peak doesn't miss a shift. Fires a shot. That's wide. Puck saved at the line by Bjorkstrand. Back here for Peak. Looking down low. Jenner was there at the side of the net. Could not corral the puck. Along the wall. Nyquist. Nyquist dancing. Steps away. Nyquist now will hustle. Plays it on the corner. Fights off the check.
He battles on puck.
Boy, is he ever.
Smart, he's shifty and strong.
Still gets it to Bjorkstrand, does Nyquist, and a shot there through his screen goes wide.
Yeah, just wide. Looked like he had that right side of the net open.
Here, Jackets move in, fire shot, scores! That all-important next goal, and the Jackets get it. Will it be Peak's goal, or other Bean's goal, or might have been deflected down low?
Wow, Jake Bean scored that goal. He's in the middle of the ice. And it's Bjorkstrand that carried the mail and dished it off to him. And nice move there. He's got Boone Jenner in front. It might have got off Boone. But the way he celebrates and points to Jake Bean, that's Jake Bean's goal. Looks like it went off of Johnson out front. Eric Johnson. So nice job by Jake Bean. keeps the puck, changes his angle, and then Boone Jenner just a wall in front of the netminder Johansson. And the Blue Jackets, after that penalty kill, have cut the deficit in half.
Indeed. Right back in this one now. Far side of the ice. Puck is played out of the zone. Bean getting his second of the young NHL season. And the Jackets looking for more as they move up ice. Laine dumps in. Sillinger, who remains out there with Voracek and Laine. Gavrikov stepping up. Avalanche have it. They'll clear the zone to the right wing feed. In and across the line. That's Helm. Trying to feed the point. Jackets will have nothing of that. Helm now from a sharp angle just threw it right across the blue paint. Ends out back in neutral ice. A little more than two to go.
Good communication by the linesman. Waved off that icing.
Bayreuther, right wing. Here's Chinnikov with a shot. Oliver Bjorkstrand draws the lone assist on the Bean goal, and here Bean rifles one wide. Werenski steps in off the point. Chinnikov up high. Good work there to keep it in.
Looks like a Jess came out for Chinnikov.
Puck sent high, gloved and held here by Jonas Korpisalo.
Jake Bean on the board for the Columbus Blue Jackets, and that's got to feel good for the young defenseman. Lots of conversation with his D partner, Zach Werenski, and how about Boone? Screen in front, the Blue Jackets are right back in it. Defenders for the Colorado Avalanche, here we go. Whoops, Yost goes the wrong way. You can see Bean, a lot of ice time now. Someone's trying to make up for the defense, and no, not happening. So the move of the game, that's Bjorkstrand crisscrossing with Bean, and then Bean a little shake and bake, and Boone Jenner right on the toes of the netminder Johansson.
Behind the net, Werenski whips it around the boards, unable to keep it in. There was Girard, Sam Girard hustling back, but it's Byram who plays the puck. Byram, right wing. O'Connor tips it to center. Blue Jackets drop it back. Nyquist. Threw it across the line. Bjorkstrand trying to get to that puck. Nyquist there. Played by Landeskog. Off McKinnon, kept in the zone. Oh, it just rolled off the stick there of Jenner, who reached back. Blue Jackets able to dump it in nonetheless. They'll get fresh legs on here. A little more than a minute to go in period two, 2-1.
Remaining in the period.
Across the line, Byram. His goal right now, the difference. Second of the two for Colorado. After a scoreless first, the Habs have a pair. And the Jackets won on the goal by Bean.
And this line for the Blue Jackets with Laine, Voracek, and Sillinger, they need to get things going offensively.
Voracek. Bayreuther, one-timer by Laine, juggled and held by Johansson.
Well, nice play, spreading the zone, low to high, then the width of the blue line, and Patrick Laine is the one there that's loaded and ready to unload. You see Voracek goes low to high, now it's going to go across your screen, and there's that stick in the air. Clean sight line for the netminder. I don't know if I'd stand in front of that shot anyways. I know Boone Jenner has.
These guys
usually high.
Laine in particular. We've seen a couple of shots tonight.
Jenner out there to take this draw. Just finished a shift with Bjorkstrand. Nyquist.
Well, when you're winning better than 60% of the faceoffs, the coach wants you out there.
I want these guys in the offensive zone. 26 seconds left in the period. This is waved off there.
Werenski away from Darren Helm. Jackets right off the forecheck. Jake Bean, rink wide, Laine full stride. Tried to walk to the net and was knocked away. Eric Johnson now, remaining seconds, sends it to center off Kadri, and there's the horn. to end yet another entertaining period here.
Yeah, it looked like as the second period started, the Blue Jackets came out on their toes the first 20 seconds, but then you know what? A bounce goes Colorado's way and they take advantage of it. They get the first two goals of the game, but the big moment, the penalty kill for the Columbus Blue Jackets, and then they come right down and Jake Bean gets on the board. Momentum back in their favor. Now, regroup and get ready and be sharp for this third period.
Should be a good one. Jonas Korpisalo has been solid. The Jackets get on the board late in the second. It's a one-goal game as we head to the intermission. Columbus Blue Jackets hockey brought to you by American Eagle Mortgage. We get you home on time, whether you're buying or refinancing. And by Ohio Health, the official healthcare provider of your Columbus Blue Jackets.
A break time in Denver, three-goal period. The Avs now lead the Jackets 2-1 as the Jackets answer back after a 2-0 start for Colorado. Welcome back inside our Bally Sports Ohio studio. That period for the Jackets started to get away just a bit with the two-goal lead for the Avs, but that answer from Jake Bean and the Jackets was big.
Yes, and that third goal is always key. If you're up 2-1 or down, I mean, if you're down 2-0 or 3-0 inside of 2-1, it's a big difference. And Jake Bean with a great goal and then great net front presence by Boone Jenner. As always, he's in front disturbing the piece, and that pays off big for the Blue Jackets. So now you head into that third period confident. You need to get that next goal.
Jackets actually had numerous other scoring chances, some of them from Cole Sillinger, the rookie, back at the rink now with Mets.
Cole, you're getting one opportunity. How do you turn that one opportunity, one or two opportunities, into more sustained pressure in the offensive zone?
Yeah, I think that just it all starts with moving our feet. We're a fast team, so get the puck, blow the hash marks, and keep moving our feet, create chances, and just get pucks up to our D and get in front of the net.
You're getting opportunities tonight between Line A and Voracek. How does that change things for you, Cole, if at all?
Yeah, I mean, for me, it doesn't really change much. I mean, we got pretty good chemistry within each other. I know them really well off the ice, so they're obviously two really great players. So we just gotta continue creating chances and hopefully put a couple shots in the back of the net.
Yeah, and a one goal game now as opposed to two. How does that impact things for the third?
Yeah, we're gonna have to push hard this third. We know they're a fast team, but we're fast as well. So yeah, like you said, you just gotta get pucks low and bury on the chances when they come to us.
Well, thanks for this.
Thank you very much.
All right, third period is on the way in Denver. The Jackets trying to close the gap a little bit more, trailing 2-1 after two.
Join us for the ABC6 Toys for Tots Drive.
Brought to you by your local Toyota dealer. Visit buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places. And by Arby's, we have the meats. Well, a 2-0 lead for the Avs, followed up by this goal from Jake Bean, JL, his second of the season, and a second period goal means what?
Curly fries, baby.
There you go.
Free curly fries tomorrow at all your participating Arby's location.
That's right. Got to be the next day, but thanks to Jake Bean getting the Jackets on the board, you get those free curly fries tomorrow. One more period to go in Denver. We're back with more in studio after this. Still right.
You lost income due to an auto accident.
2-1 at Ball Arena in Denver. Jake Bean got the Jackets on the board. There were opportunities, though, aside from the Bean goal. In fact, several came just before the Avalanche put two on the board first. But you see some of these, JL. What do you notice about what the Jackets have done well tonight?
Well, they attack with purpose, and here it is Gus Nyquist. He's got nothing, takes that shot, and almost beats the goaltender. And then great speed there by Gregory Hoffman around. And I love this shot right here. Look at Boone Jenner, what he's going to do. He's just plowing, and it's not a cross check. He's just pushing, and what are you doing, Boone? He's clearing the front.
That's right.
It's the offensive zone. He's just disturbing the peace, as they say. I love it. And then it's going to lead to that goal with Jake Bean in front because it creates frustration. Yeah. Goaltender, defensemen don't like that. And you know he's in your head, and that's what number 38 is really good at.
Plowing was good for Boone.
Yeah,
the Avs, each time they scored, Logan O'Connor and then the two-on-one, Kadri and Byram, each time just before that, the Jackets had a good scoring opportunity on the other end of the ice, so it's been that kind of a game. But again, the Jackets 3-for-3 on the kills so far, or this could be very different.
Yes, the penalty kill is big. Jonas Korpisalo is playing extremely well. And Andrew Peak with a fantastic block shot. It looked like it hurt, but great job by him. But for Blue Jackets, you have to be careful because transition is what the Colorado Avalanche thrives on. And we saw Landeskog and McKinnon a few times finding some open ice and just going through everyone.
All right, can the Jackets even it up? Take a lead. We're about to find out as we send you back to the rink with the Jackets down a goal after two.
Period play. Build a schedule that works best for you and save more than 40% on single game pricing with the 8-game flex plan. Learn more. Visit bluejackets.com/flex. Jeff River, Jody Shelley rejoining you here at the Ball Arena. And Jody, your thoughts?
Great game. I mean, you're playing the Colorado Avalanche. I know they're missing a lot of weapons, but Nathan McKinnon and company, they're playing well. And the Blue Jackets are crowding them, doing a nice job. Korpisalo only let in two goals, and the Blue Jackets' penalty kill has been perfect. So on script, and right now, you know, they started the second pretty well, but it's time now, as we look at the Capital Kia game summary, for these Blue Jackets led by Jonas Korpisalo, giving them a chance to be in this game and win this game. Time to come out and generate. Get a power play, Jeff. How about that?
I think it's long overdue. The Avalanche have had three. The Blue Jackets are looking for their first. 9 shots for Colorado on their 3 power plays this evening. Twice they've peppered Jonas Korpisalo with 4 shots. Puck dumped in, Werenski able to knock it down and keep it away from the Avalanche forward, Compher. Compher, the second effort, dumps it below the goal line. A quick feed here for Bjorkstrand, Oliver Bjorkstrand. Nyquist, and here is Jenner. Scoots in, tries to cut to the net, throws it right through the blue paint. Girard, Sam Girard, looking for Byram. Cut off along the wall there, Bjorkstrand. Jenner and Nyquist working deep in Colorado territory. Oh, that one's off Johnson.
Hard-working veteran line here with a lot of skill. Put them together about midway through that second period, and they're going to stay together.
Landeskog takes it from comfort. Leans his way to center. Dumps in and then heads off to the bench. Both teams change up here on the fly. Werenski. Puck left right there. Puck is chopped ahead. Bounces wide of the net. Quick feed for Jack. Redirected by Sillinger. And the Jackets have tied it.
Started in their own end deep. Cole Sillinger with his second in the National Hockey League. And Zach Werenski at the end of a shift. It's a heads-up breakout, a tip in the neutral zone. And then Voracek with speed. And as he gets that puck, it's all in one motion. Here's Jake retrieving that breakout, and there's the play by Cole Sillinger right in front of the net. Jack Johnson can't believe it. Cole Sillinger's got his stick down on the ice. He's planted. And as Jake and him are on the same page, it's strong stick, nice pass, and it's in the back of the net. We're tied up.
Cole Sillinger rewarded with better than 11 minutes through 40 minutes of play here. And earning that ice time, and he's tied it up with his second. Voracek will pick up an assist on the redirected the slot in front of Johansson. 2-2. As we approach the 2-minute mark here of the third period, Avalanche with the first 2 goals, the Jackets have fought back. And now here they come again, across the line, Chinnikov. Now picked up by Roslovic. Jack Roslovic looks to the point. Coming off the bench there was Pete. Bayreuther tried to chop it towards the net. Roslovic able to get it right back. Chinnikov with a shot. Stick save. Rebound. Comes back up high. Jackets on the prowl looking for the go-ahead goal. And it's dropped back to the point by Roslovic. Gabriel Carlson had peeled in off the point. Retreats off the shoulder, and Johansson will hold.
Nice shot by Yegor Chinnikov. Nice shift by those guys. Here's back to the goal. This is just the look at the pass from Jake to Cole. Started deep in the defensive zone off of Zach Werenski. Just a heads up, controlled breakout, waited. And Laine was in the middle of the ice. Deflection play, and then on their toes on the forecheck. And what jump do they have right now?
Absolutely.
Love the puck.
Big rebound. Another attempt there from point blank range. Nyquist sent it over top of the net, and the zone is cleared. You know, you have to laugh here. Cole Sillinger has had some pretty good opportunities after scoring his first NHL goal with some quality shots, big saves. Here, stick down, just redirects it and ties it up with a huge goal. And the Avalanche,
Jeff,
block.
Go to the net with your stick on the ice. You've heard that forever, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Especially with Jake Voracek out there.
What a play.
Yeah, strong play, good hustle.
You said something in the second period. Remember this play.
It was that shot block by Andrew Peak on the penalty kill.
Exactly.
You know, that was one of the keys tonight. Try to stay on that power play of the Avalanche.
And now the Jackets are even with the Avalanche here in Colorado. First of back-to-backs. They'll play it nationwide Saturday night. Hope to see you there. The Avalanche have not had a shot since the 5:10 mark of the second period.
Wow.
That's 5:10 remaining.
Yeah.
8-plus minutes, no shots on goal. And the Jackets all over the Avalanche here in the early moments of the third.
Yeah, they're buzzing. They're right in the hip pocket of every play. And these past two shifts in the offensive zone, it's shot or pass, and it looks like it's going to go the other way, but they jump on it and get it back.
Kadri trying to squeeze through. That one fought off. Batted out of the air by Korpisalo. Ryan Murray tosses to the corner. Carlson trying to protect that puck. Sillinger trying to dig it free. O'Connor dropped to the ice by Sillinger. Jackets off the wall. Sillinger with a puck. Quickly deals. Right side. Moving in. Another redirect. Scores! What was that? Stick on the ice again! And the Jackets take the lead. What a feed from Gabriel Carlson. And Sillinger puts it into the net. The Jackets with their first lead.
Well, you talk about this kid and what he's done, and I tell you what, he's been knocking on the door. And he goes to the net with a stick on the ice, but it starts in the defensive zone. Hustle, body, and he gets position, and then he gets the legs going up the ice. And Gabriel Carlson, what a pass across. And Sillinger stops on the blue paint. And he's got two tonight, three on the year, and the Blue Jackets have their lead. Details and the appreciation from the entire bench and the coaching staff. You ask players, especially the center ice position, to take care of those details defensively. And when you do and you get rewarded, wow, what a game for Cole Sillinger.
First two-goal effort in the National Hockey League. This game 9 for the 18-year-old.
That conversation is over, that 10-game mark.
Oh, I don't think it was ever in the books, to be honest with you.
I agree with you, but, you know, as a rookie, he's thinking about it. Now he cannot go back to junior after he plays his 10th game.
Never a doubt in my mind. So, one assist, that to Carlson with another feed to the slot.
Every shift that he's been out there, to be quite honest, we've noticed him. And lines have been changed. Boone Jenner and Cole Sillinger are the top two centermen on this team.
Jackets come again. Up along the left wing. Bayreuther got a piece of Jost. The Avalanche back on their heels. It is all Columbus right now. Jackets looking for more. Saved at the line by Gavrikov. Jenner behind the net. Jenner with a wraparound attempt. MacKinnon pumped off the puck there by Gavrikov. Jackets control. Jenner to the offensive blue line. Moves in. Looks for open ice. Fires a shot and it's wide. Eric Johnson. Slips and falls. Jackets Hockey to get something going. That was Nyquist who knocked down. Johnson tries to retrieve the puck. Bjorkstrand with an attempt. Compher now. Off the wall. Puck in front. And Korpisalo denies Landeskog, who is all alone. Right there in on the net, by
it looked like Korpisalo was drifting as Landeskog went against the grain, but Korpisalo got that big right leg out. Made the save.
Kadri now throws it behind the net. Bayreuther. Jackets march out. Voracek. Andrew Peake. Puck is dumped in. Voracek. Nice to play it along the left wing wall. Sillinger right there with him. Voracek. Tied up. Avalanche will send it high and out. Peake. Briefly holding up O'Connor. Icing is the call against the Avalanche.
Avalanche on their heels. They don't have an answer for the Blue Jackets. Just relentless work on pucks. And there's Gavrikov as he tries to step up. And Jonas Korpisalo says, no problem, Gavi. I got you here with a big save.
Love it.
Yeah, you know, they're just playing free and on their toes. And it seems like every line that comes over the boards has that same attitude. You know, make the play, but then follow it up to get those pucks back. And here's Chinikov on the forecheck on a faceoff loss.
Hoffman dangling on the far side. Chinikov. Roslovic. Chinikov. Hanging on. Chinikov deals to the point. Looked around the board, stepping up. The man that started the scoring for the Jackets tonight, Jake Bean, with his second of the young season. Now chip pass to the right wing. Corrali in pursuit. Jack Johnson sends it far side. Here's Jost. Steps in and across the line. Crowd looking for another penalty to be called. Werenski takes a hit. Korpisalo just left it there. Back to Werenski. And now a touch pass. On that left wing, Texier defending as Girard, who sweeps it away. Jost is just drilled there by Corrali. Referee chant back in force here. Texier will hustle to it. Eric Johnson gets a stick on it. Gets it ahead for Darren Helm. Helm at center. He'll just rifle in and then head off to the bench. Korpisalo out of the net. Holds off the Avalanche forward. Retreats back in the blue paint. Jackets control and hustle out of the zone. Sherwood able to steal, albeit momentarily, and then just chopped the rest of the way by Eric Robinson. That's center. Jackets dump in. Ryan Murray pressured there by his opposite number, Oliver Bjorkstrand. Bjorkstrand trying to fish it free. Does. Gets it up high. Bayreuther with a shot. It's blocked. Bayreuther a second attempt. Able to keep it in. Along the wall. That's Landeskog. Trying to feather a pass. The Jackets just smothering the Avalanche. Here they come again. Jenner with a shot. Juggled. Rebound. Scores! Jenner sent it to the net. I don't know if it's his or Gavrikov. Nonetheless, the Jackets lead by two.
Oh, looks like Boone Jenner all the way here. Gavrikov is the middle lane drive. But Boone Jenner, yeah, it's the third period. He wants to get involved. Why not? Starts in the neutral zone with Boone. He's got the ice, he's got the time. And right there, not just the shot, the follow-up. That's the key. A lot of people would drift by the net here. Not Boone Jenner. Stays on it, tracks that puck, shovels it back towards Johansson. And the Blue Jackets have a two-goal lead here in Denver.
Right off the skate of Johansson. Jenner with his sixth of the season.
Yeah, how about the play by Nyquist in the neutral zone there? Takes the hit. Yeah, chips it to speed. That sends them on their way. Here's a line that wants to get involved.
It's all Columbus here. And a well-deserved 4-2 lead. Left wing, the Jackets unable to clear. Puck just rolled off the stick of Laine. Sillinger flips it high. Rolling puck. Laine with Voracek offside.
Patrick Laine doesn't believe it, but yeah, too many moves at the line for Patrick as Boone Jenner makes it 4-2. Third for the Avalanche, but Zach Werenski, nice play up the wall, gets tipped. Jake Voracek knows where he's going, so does Cole Sillinger to the net with his stick on the ice. Try that again. That's a different goal from Gabriel Carlson on a two-on-one, and then Boone Jenner, three quick goals for the Blue Jackets, who have been all over the Colorado Avalanche. Relentless would be a good word, and there are your goal scorers here in the third period.
Four straight goals by Columbus after the Avalanche had built up a 2-0 lead midway through the second period. But some strong penalty killing and some big saves as Corposalo held the fort until the offense could get going. The Jackets lead here as we've now hit the 10-minute mark of period three. Bjorkstrand hands it off, gets it right back from Nyquist, moves to the front of the net, then rifles it just wide. Nyquist and Bjorkstrand, incidentally, both picking up assists on that Jenner goal. Jack Johnson, right wing, Avalanche into Columbus territory. That's Jost with it along the wall. Feeds it behind the net for O'Connor. O'Connor walking out. O'Connor up high, traffic in front of Corposalo. Right across the goal mouth. Scramble in front, loose puck, wraparound attempt. Corposalo gets a piece of that, tries to cover up, and he's upset there. He thought he had the puck long enough. Has a word with the official. Meantime, there's a little pushing and shoving.
Yeah, you got Nyquist behind the net with O'Connor, who's having a night. Good speed on the entry, and now you can see the frustration of the Avalanche. There's the play. Let's keep an eye on the blue paint here as the Blue Jackets want to protect that. You see Corposalo, he lunges across there. Now he's just laying out waiting for the puck. He's got it, but now takes an extra poke, and that's what he's upset about. He's actually going to pick it up with his blocker. Puck's going to come back. He picks it up right there. He's got it. And there's an extra poke that he does not appreciate whatsoever. Big boy McDermott is in there. Smikes the puck. There's Jonas Corposalo. You see McDermott off to the left. His dad Paul played for 14 years in the National Hockey League. Tough customers.
9:21 remaining in regulation. Comfer wins the draw, but the Jackets come up with a puck nonetheless. Gloved, and since it was gloved ahead, play is whistled down. And there's 9:15 left. We step aside. More to come. Shootwide Arena, Hockey for Her, presented by Myers Jewelers, a series of events that focus on educating our female fans on the various aspects of the game of hockey. Our first event, Monday, November 15th. Register now at bluejackets.com/hockeyforher.
One guy we haven't talked about much tonight is this guy, Vladislav Gavrikov. He steps in tonight. He's got Bayreuther as a new D partner, and he just played really solid right from the opening shift. Defensively, down around his own net, and then offensively, we saw him up there on the Jenner goal. So confident. Talk about his personality. Yeah, he's a breath of fresh air. There's no question. But establishing himself as such a big, strong force back there as a defenseman for the Blue Jackets. They're going to do this drop again. Take three. Huh. Had to put some time. Make sure the clock is right.
Referee Brad Meyer came over and checked with the timekeeper. We're ready to go.
Boone's going to get kicked out, so Oliver steps in. Good job by Oliver. Be on to something. I think he's 2-for-2 tonight.
Bayreuther jumps in deep. McKinnon. Comfort. Bayreuther. Landeskog cuts it off. He's got McKinnon with him. Jackets get it right back. They have frustrated this top line all night long.
Now that was a key coming in. I mean, they're a team that they're a line that's so explosive. They're missing Rantanen, and he is out. But still, having a superstar like McKinnon, you always have to be alert.
He was flying in that first period. Jackets have pretty well negated them since. 8.5 minutes left in regulation. Bjorkstrand up high. Bean with a shot off the goalpost. Right off the pipe. Near side. Bean gets some help from Jenner to keep it in the zone. Jenner will get a well-deserved rest. Line A dropped behind the net by Byram. A backhand pass. Landeskog cannot corral it. He'll chop it off the wall. Werenski defending. The two go to the corner. Landeskog hit there by the youngster Sillinger. It goes to the ice. He has been all over the ice.
Great in the defensive zone, too. I mean, really effective in taking care of that position.
Landeskog wondering, who is that number 34? The Johnson brothers are on the blue line. Really not brothers, but Eric and Jack. Offensive pairing. Puck set ahead by Helm. Off the shoulder there of Sherwood. Korpisalo.
His mask is undone. He's signaling to the ref that my mask is loose.
Bushels oblivious to it for the moment. On the breakup. And now finally aware as the Jackets march up ice.
Yeah,
they
took
whistle
some time
down
there for Jonas to get that whistle blown. Been deflected by Patrick. Looked like it was off the defenseman, actually. Then off the post. There's Cole on Gabriel Landeskog, making sure he eliminates the player and then gets the feet moving. Yeah, he's earning it tonight. I mean, he's getting a lot of ice time. He's got so many shots, 5 shots last game. Did a nice job, actually, in that loss in New York. The Rangers. He's already played 14-10 tonight.
Out of the corner. Moving in. Just a great move by Eric Robinson. A little how do you do to the defenseman. But Johansson is able to come up with that puck.
Yeah, he walked 2 guys there. This is the Corrali Texier Robinson line. Robinson's on the forecheck, and here he comes. Whoa.
Ryan Murray.
Good play here between the legs, and then Murray reaches in, and Robinson tiptoes around him. So lots of rhythm to this game for the Blue Jackets, this third period especially. Short shifts. That's been an effective formula here. They just keep coming wave after wave and staying fresh.
Jenner wins another draw. There's a line right back out there. And the puck goes off the netting and out of play. We'll pause now for this word from Kia.
Presenting Kia's lineup of exceptionally capable all-wheel drive SUVs.
Draw one by the Avalanche. Ranta moves it up the near boards, icing. Hey, fifth line, want a chance to win a signed Max Domi game use stick? Well, simply text the word MAX to 26791 for your chance to win. That's keyword MAX, 26791. Message and data rates may apply. So the Roslovic line out here now. Chinikov and Hoffman looking to add some magic. Johnson off the wall. Neutral zone play. Up the far boards. Avalanche now will get an opportunity to switch things up after the icing call. Hoffman drops it back from center. Redirected there by Roslovic, who bounces it right in on Johansson. Johnson up the wing. McKinnon cannot corral it. Girard, Sam Girard. Left side for Comfort. That hops over his stick.
You know, there's no. Patrick Laine is not on the bench for the Columbus Blue Jackets, Jeff. We'll keep an eye on that.
Left wing. Into the zone. Jenner puts the brakes on. Protects that puck. Drops it there. And Nyquist unable to control it. And it's back out to neutral ice. Now Kadri across the line. Taken out of the play. Werenski with the body check. Landeskog finishes the check there on Bean. Jackets now marching right back out. Down the right wing and across the line, trying to cut in. Blue Jackets continue to battle there. Now Kadri. Johnson. O'Connor icing.
It was close. Crowd not happy whatsoever.
They haven't been happy all night.
Well, I think they're a little frustrated too. I think they were cruising at 2-0 and then the Blue Jackets would not go away, which is a great trade, right? So yeah, there's no Patrick Laine on the bench for the Columbus Blue Jackets. Keep an eye on that situation as Roslovic's going to have this face-off. Chinnikov to his right. I just love it. It's wave after wave for this team right now.
They have built the momentum.
Yeah, and you think sometimes, you know, you get down, you get off your game, you try to do so much. It wasn't that way at all. They regrouped in that second period intermission. I just came out and played, went after it, actually. Just said, let's go.
And then the Bean goal late in the second period just ignited the team.
It was that kill, too. I mean, that was a big moment.
Oh, for sure. But from that point on, it's been all Blue Jackets. And a well-deserved two-goal lead here. With less than five to go. Backhanded there by Chinnikov. Deep in Colorado territory. Jack Johnson. Hoffman now will race off the ice. Byram. Dumped in deep. Werenski whips it around the wall. Cut off there on the right wing.
They cannot get possession time right now on the Blue Jackets' end whatsoever. They're trying to get down and get set up, but really have not been set up whatsoever this third period in the Blue Jackets' end.
Texier tried to get a stick on that puck. Bean now will get there. Megna cruising, right-handed centerman, but it's the Jackets break out of the zone before Megna. The second effort chops it back in. Now a long stretch pass there, missing Texier.
That was a big play by Texier to touch that puck and not allow icing. With tired players out there.
Ryan Murray dumps in deep. Bjorkstrand able to corral it along the wall, chips it out to center. Murray gets it ahead. Ryan Murray back. Eric Johnson scored in the previous game, better than 600 games between goals for him. And here he sends it out of play on the deflection. 3:33 remaining here in the third period. The Blue Jackets celebrate. Sillinger with a pair tonight.
Boat, head medical trainer, was off the bench. He's back, but Patrick is still in the room, and this was his last shift. We're not sure if this is where he got injured, but this is the last contact we saw with him. He did just get tangled up with Byram. He did finish the shift. We'll see if there's anything else, but that's what we come up with right now as the Blue Jackets getting ready. 3:33 left. Boone Jenner, he's not happy with the linesman.
Puck is dropped. Byram sends it to the half wall. McKinnon waiting up high. Shot scores. Shot from Byram.
Well, that was a quick play. Empty net goal for the Colorado Avalanche, and it's just textbook win a faceoff. Stack it up in front of the goalie and let one sail through. And this one sails through and finds the back of the net. Looks to me like it might have got touched somewhere along the way. But it's a faceoff win. That's a big detail, and there's that deflection. Might have been Comfer a little high out. Yeah, right there. JT Comfer with the deflection. No chance for Jonas Korpisalo. This crowd is back to life. And then Boone Jenner, just before that puck was dropped, he had something to say to the linesman. You know, you get set, you try to anticipate the drop, get the edge. He had to back off, and then that faceoff went the other way, and they're back within one.
So, one goal game, less than 3.5 minutes left. Johansson back in the net. Landeskog. Up the left wing to center. Byram picks up an assist. As does Kadri.
How about Hoffman out there instead of Line A? He's out there with Sillinger and Voracek with 2.5 minutes to go in a one-goal game.
Puck is dumped deep.
And this is why, because he's got speed on the forecheck. Hoffman trying to disrupt up ice. Good job by these guys.
Along the wall. Puck is sent to center. Jackets get it right back. Here they come. Across the line. Shot. Fought up. Rebound. Where is it? Down and the glove on it. He looked behind him briefly.
Yeah.
Johansson.
Interesting. Looked like it was up in the air, maybe on his shoulder. I don't know. He couldn't find the puck. Good. Just great pursuit of the puck by the Blue Jackets. They keep it in. Oh, it was close to offside, but Texier starts it with the hard shot. Where's the puck? There it finally drops. You can see Hoffman right on the doorstep of this one. There, that was on his pad. And then as it dropped, Hoffman and Johansson saw it at the same time.
Jenner line out there now. Face off to the right. From the draw, Jenner in the corner. He went toe-to-toe.
Yeah, he wanted on that corner. He looked like he was ready to slide in the corner and go jump on the puck. So he got his way.
Girard will pick it up. Johansson. Deep. In that blue paint. Avalanche dump in. They change up here on the fly. Less than two to go. Cross ice pass gets away from McKinnon, bouncing off the wall, and it's icing at a critical faceoff. Back into the Blue Jackets' end, but not before we pause for this word from Jets Pizza.
We see your mouth watering. Go ahead, order now. Jets.
I was watching Johansson there. He was still in his crease.
Yeah.
And McKinnon went over to Bednar and said, hey, tell him to get out of there. Oh, Nate McKinnon directing traffic right now in the offensive zone. Jenner on his right side going against Landeskog.
Huge draw here.
See Boone again, he's not happy with that linesman. He does stick with it though.
And wins it.
Wins it and takes a cross check to the back.
Nyquist with the net empty. Maybe another faceoff here. With an icing call, right back into the Columbus end.
That was right under the stick of Bo Byram, that clearing attempt, too. I mean, the defensemen are so smart with these plays, because if he touches it, there's no icing.
Right.
But he lets it go by him just enough, so now they're set up again. Landeskog is going to get tossed here, so it'll change things up, bring Kadri in.
From the draw, Avalanche. Landeskog takes it from McKinnon, back to McKinnon, chopped to Byram, but he can't make the play. He's got to shovel it off into the corner. Jenner comes up with it. Ripped around the boards. And again, we're going to get an icing here. Same players remain on for Columbus.
Those faceoffs are so important right now. And you know, the timing of the drop and the jump these players want to have. All wingers. Nyquist is ready to jump. There's that last one. Looked like it bounced quite a bit off the ice. This one, again, goes Colorado's way.
Byram deals, gets it back. McKinnon, oh, unable to make the play. Shot down and just missing the net.
Oh, Gus Nyquist just missed the net. What a play by him. Goodhart's tries to get out in open ice. He cannot believe he missed that empty net. I think we watched him yesterday put one in. They played a game after. He had to put it over the net and into the empty net from the goal line. He did it easily, but there, just a little too much hook on that, so now back.
I remember 2 years ago, he was Mr. Empty Net.
Yeah, that's right, he was.
Long shot there, scores! Byram from the point, tie game.
Yeah, that's unfortunate because, you know, the Blue Jackets, two-goal lead, and here it's icing and icing. And Colorado, with their big boys out there, win three consecutive faceoffs. And it's a similar play. It's a shot from the middle of the ice through traffic, and you got a couple guys trying to block it. But nothing fancy here, as it's one pass and then a one-time shot with heat. And Jonas Korpisalo's reaction says it all. I can't see a thing. I mean, he can't see a thing there, so Blue Jackets, and you see Nyquist at the bottom left of your screen. He's not happy that he missed that open net by about 4 inches.
Byram's got his second of the night, third of the season. Two late goals with the goaltender pulled, and we are tied 4-4, well into the final minute of regulation. Eric Johnson now off the wall. Jacket trying to freeze it there. Texier trying to get a stick on it. Kadri out. Kadri's second effort, able to sweep it in. Korpisalo, a quick feed here to Werenski. Texier at center. Texier dumps in. Out there with Voracek. Deep in the zone. It goes off the glass, up into the netting. We'll get a faceoff.
Well, Byram's having a night. I mean, he's a couple goals and an assist. We talked about Makar being out. But Byram, the 20-year-old confident rookie, has whistled two in. And one with the goaltender pulled. The other one was a deflection off of his shot. So now the Blue Jackets going to try something of their own here. As Boone Jenner to take it again. He's got Zach Werenski out there. A little conversation with Bjorkstrand and Werenski. We'll see what happens here on this draw.
From the faceoff. Our side, that's McKinnon. Works it up the boards. Werenski with it, tried to send it towards the net.
Wow, McKinnon there with a bad decision.
Now Werenski. Jake Bean partially fanning on his shot as the horn goes to end regulation. And the Jackets playing game number 9 for the fourth time are headed to overtime.
I don't think McKinnon knew how much time was left on the clock.
No.
That play was a weak play off the wall, and Werenski almost made him pay with that pass to Bean, but exciting third period, and unfortunately for the Blue Jackets, gave up two with an empty net for the Avalanche, and we're headed to overtime.
Stay with us, late night hockey from the Rocky Mountains. Blue Jackets going to overtime as the Avalanche score a pair late.
Well, they're missing Patrick Laine, Jeff, off that bench. Well, let's go back to some excitement. The second period, Cole Sillinger stick on the ice again. Textbook. Blue Jackets get the 2-goal lead, 4-2 by Boone Jenner. Yeah! Unfortunately, that was all in the third period. This was late in the third period. With the goaltender pulled. Too many icings led to faceoffs, faceoff lost. Too many opportunities, and the Blue Jackets are tied up, headed to overtime. Jenner to take the draw against Landeskog. Werenski having some words for Bjorkstrand. It's McKinnon and Landeskog out there. There goes Boone, and with no Patrick Laine, Mr. 3-on-3 hero, that's Nyquist out there.
So, Bjorkstrand gets it cross ice for Werenski. Just underway. Landeskog, McKinnon work up front. Nyquist, McKinnon heads off. Landeskog is there. Left wing pass. Werenski jumping up, cannot corral the puck. Girard, Sam Girard now. A quick feed through the neutral zone and across the line. Confer waiting on the right side. Shot blocked there by Bean. Bean then able to steal it away and hands it to Jake Voracek. Cole Sillinger out there, two nice goals for young Cole. Now across the line, deals to Sillinger, on to Bean. Bean hanging on, finds Voracek, rolls off his stick, able to recover, keeps it away from Comfer. Here's Bean moving in, fires, scores! Jackets win in overtime! Bean with his second of the night on a feed from Jake Voracek.
How about Jake Voracek? Completely slows the game down right from the second he gets the puck behind his net. They work it around the offensive zone, and it looked like Voracek was going to lose the puck. But as he gets the puck back, He just slows it down again and gets it to Jake Bean, who just rips it past Johansson. And the Blue Jackets celebrate his second of the night. And he's your IGS Energy Performer. Energy Report Reformer. Performer.
You got it.
Stick with me. Here's the replay. This is what we want to see right here. Jake Voracek stops on it. You can see here, double coverage. Doesn't panic, gets it to Jake Bean. It's all alone.